I'm Christine Mason. I'm CEO of Spring CM, which is located right here in the Apparel Center in Chicago. We were founded in 2002 as another company, but we spun out into two separate operating units. And Spring just launched as an independent organization this year in February, February 1st. We have 27 employees currently and are up to 85 enterprise customers as of this past week. We serve companies like Avon and GE, as well as other departments in enterprise, and lots of smaller organizations, particularly their IT departments, and help them automate their content and document processes. You see a problem, you see a need, and there's a road in front of you, and all you need to do is map that out and put the resources in place and orchestrate it, and it happens. It's like architecting. It's very satisfying because you can move much more quickly than you can embedded within a mature organization where there are trade-offs around priorities. You can set that vision and just go for it. It's so satisfying. The creative component and then the immediate feedback loop between your action and results with not a lot of noise in between. I started my first business when I was 16. I was early in college and had a fitness business, and then I had a catering company when my kids were little. And then I went to B school and thought, oh, I'm going to get some traditional experience, M&A, big consulting, big brands, and very valuable, good basic training, but again, not that creative for us. So we started working with companies on joint ventures and new market growth strategies. So it was almost like entrepreneurship, and then went into e-commerce and technology just at the right time. And that process was so satisfying that my partners and I started an incubator. And we did 12 companies in 2 years.
And what was the name of that? I'm sorry.
Click Markets.
Okay.
Click Markets. And the idea was that you could take any technology, and the goal was to get a clicking, recurring revenue stream off of that product. And then if you architected your business from the beginning for that, you know, it'll be clicking along. Click has a much different meaning now from Google than it did then. But we did a lot of early stage, seed stage technology transfer deals, trying to get something out of the lab. And then moved on into later and later stage deals. And this is a pretty mature technology. The time between invention and revenue was only 3 months compared to a technology transfer deal at the earlier stage, which like invention and revenue is years.
Becoming an entrepreneur for the first time, maybe you at 16, looking to start your first thing, or maybe even a little bit older, what would be the advice you'd give?
Ask more questions from people that you can model it after. Get more advice, build your own personal advisory board of mentors that have nothing to do with the business, and then do that in return. Be prepared to give it away, give it away, give it away, to anybody who needs your help, because it really comes back. So ask questions. And then the other one is, you know, don't be afraid to think really, really big. You don't really get rewarded for thinking of incremental things. You get rewarded for being vision and giving people something that they can really get excited about putting their life energy into. So it's not stress on others. It's actually inspiring to them. And third is never lose sight of what the really, really important things are, whether it's family or play or your health or your spiritual development or whatever it happens to be for you, because the business will always be there. And you have to keep filling that pipe with energy from outside of you in order to keep giving it to others. So balance, mentorship, and vision, those would be my piece of advice.